Hi children, I hope you all are safe at home with your parents. Today we are going to see chapter 4. Children, we know physiographic divisions in India. We discussed in previous video. Do you remember? How many physiographic divisions are there in India? How many physiographic divisions are there in India? 6 physiographic divisions. What are the 6 physiographic divisions? What are the 6 physiographic divisions? There are the Northern Mountains, the Northern Plains, the Great Indian Desert, the Southern Plateau, the Coastal Plains, and the Islands. Children, in previous video, we discussed the Northern Mountains and the Northern Plains. Now, we will see the Great Indian Desert. So, what is chapter 4? Yes, the Great Indian Desert. In this video, we are going to discuss various things about the Great Indian Desert. In this video, we are going to discuss various things about Thar Desert. Where is Thar Desert located? Let's see. The Great Indian Desert, also known as the Thar Desert, it is located in the northwestern part of India, in the state of Rajasthan. It is located in the northwestern part of India, in the state of Rajasthan. The Thar Desert is bordered by the Satluj River on the northeast. It has a salt marsh known as the Ran of Kutch towards its south. What is salt marsh? An area of coastal grassland that is regularly flooded by seawater. An area of coastal grassland that is regularly flooded by seawater. To the southeast lies the range of Aravalli Hills, and the desert extends west into Pakistan till the Indus River basin. Let's discuss about the landform. The desert has an undulating surface with high and low sand dunes. So children, what is the meaning of undulating surface? Having a smoothly rising and falling form. Having a smoothly rising and falling form, like wave. And what is sand dunes? A small hills of sand formed due to the deposit of large amount of sand carried by wind. A small hills of sand formed due to the deposit of large amount of sand carried by wind. In Tamil, Manal Meadu. So, the desert has an undulating surface with high and low sand dunes. Winds in the desert region move the sand dunes from one place to another. These dunes are in continuous motion and take on varying shapes and size. Moving one place to another place, it will change shapes and sizes. The sand dunes may rise to a height of 500 feet. It may rise to a height of 500 feet. Children, please imagine yourself. You are standing on desert area. What do you see in the desert? First of all, we see sand. Whenever we speak about desert, normally we thought sand. But there are many different kinds of soil found in Thar Desert, such as the desert soil, brown grey soil, red and yellow soils, and soft loose soil called rigosol. I will repeat you again. Desert soil, brown grey soil, red and yellow soils, and soft loose soil called rigosol. I will repeat you again. Desert soil, brown gray soil, red and yellow soils, and soft loose soil called rigosol. These soils are not fertile. It means it's not suitable for plants. Because of severe wind erosion, they are blown away with the sand. Here, dust storms are common in the months of May and June. Storms, it means puyal. This region hardly receives any rainfall. The desert absorbs an extreme type of climate. During summer, the days are long and the temperature is scorching hot. It means very hot. Hot and dry winds blow during the day. The nights are, however, cooler. This is because the sand heats up quickly during the day and cools down quickly during the night. At night, the heat escapes into the atmosphere, which significantly cools down the temperature. In winter, the days are pleasant. However, the nights are bitterly cold. In summer, the days are long and the temperature is very hot. In winter, the days are pleasant. However, the nights are bitterly cold. Here, rainfall is very scanty in the desert. Scanty, it means very less. So, here, very less rainfall. During summer, temperature varies from 45 to 50 degrees Celsius. During winter, the temperature varies from 4 degrees Celsius to 10 degrees Celsius. During summer, the temperature varies from 45 to 50 degrees Celsius. During winter, the temperature varies from 4 degrees Celsius to 10 degrees Celsius. Let's discuss about water in the Thar Desert. There is scarcity of water in the Thar Desert. So children, what is scarcity? The state of being scarce or in short supply. So the Thar Desert does not receive enough rainfall and also has no rivers passing through this region. It has enough rainfall and also has no rivers passing through this region. So, water from the seasonal rainfall is collected in tanks and reservoirs and is used for drinking and domestic purpose. So, water from the seasonal rainfall is collected in tanks and reservoirs and is used for drinking and domestic purpose. People are now reverting to storing water by using traditional methods of water storage. This water becomes a major problem of this region. So, nowadays, lack of rainfall. People are storing water by using traditional methods of water storage. Canals are an important source of water supply in the desert region. Here, canals are important source of water supply. The Indira Gandhi Canal irrigates a vast amount of land in the Thar Desert. It is the longest canal of India. So children, which is the longest canal of India? The Indira Gandhi Canal. Indira Gandhi Canal is the longest canal of India. The canal begins at the Karkai Barrage. The canal begins at the Karak Barrage, where the rivers Satluj and Bias meet. Where the rivers Satluj and Bias meet, it called Karak Barrage, and continues in southwest direction for 470 km.
The Indira Gandhi Canal starts from the Satluj River to different parts of the Thar Desert that brings water of this Satluj River into Rajasthan. The solving drinking water problem as well as agriculture activity. And hydroelectric power is supplied to a number of towns by the Bakra Nangal power plant. It is located on the Satluj River in Punjab. So, the Bakra Nangal dam has been built across the Satluj River. There are a few roadways and railways lines in this region. And one more interesting fact, the Bakra Nangal dam is one of the highest straight gravity dam in the world. Which is the highest straight gravity dam in the world? The Bakra Nangal dam. At some places in the desert, the underground water comes to the surface. Such a place in the desert which has water and thus vegetation is referred to as an oasis. So what is definition of oasis? A fertile spot in a desert where water is found. It also makes its surrounding region fertile due to shortened plants start growing in this region. You can also see like dates palm and purple in this region. The Thar Desert is also blessed to have an oasis that becomes source of fresh water and helps us to few village groundwater this region. What kind of trees and plants we find here? Due to scanty rainfall in the desert region, the vegetation mostly consists of herbs or small plants. So children, what do you mean by scanty rainfall? It means very less or low rainfall. So due to the low rainfall in desert region, the vegetation mostly consists of herbs or small plants. Some hardy trees which can bear the drought conditions can be seen at a few places. And one more thing, the Kejri tree grows in the desert region and it is also the state tree of Rajasthan. Which is the state tree of Rajasthan? Kejri tree. The Kejri tree is the state tree of Rajasthan. Let's talk about animals found here. Animals which can survive harsh weather conditions are found in this region. So, animals which can survive in tough weather conditions are found in this region. The great Indian buster, an endangered species. What do you mean by endangered? Plant or animal that is in danger of disappearing forever. Plant or animal that is in danger of disappearing forever. So, buster and endangered species is found in this region. Other animals that are present in the region are black buck, cheetah deer, nilgai, quail, duck, geese, the hardy camel. Black bucks, cheetah deer, nilgai, quail, duck, geese and the hardy camel are present in this region. Which animal is called the sheep of the desert? Camel. The camel is also called the sheep of the desert because it can survive without water for a few days. Camels do not sweat and have padded feet which help them to walk on the sand easily. It is also used to carry loads. In the border areas, camels are used by the armed forces for patrolling and guards the international boundary. So what do you mean by patrolling? It means traveling around it. The camel skin is used to make bags, belts, shoes and other items. People also domesticate the camel for milk and for food. What do you mean by the word domesticate? It means cultivate for food. And one more interesting fact. Camel can carry over 200 kilograms on their backs. It can carry over 200 kilograms on their backs. And it can walk 4 kilograms per hour through the hot desert. It can walk 4 kilometers. Some interesting things about camel. Camel can carry over 200 kilograms on their backs. It can carry over 200 kilograms. It can walk 4 kilometers per hour through the hot desert. It can walk 4 kilometers per hour through the hot desert. And they can go like this for 3 weeks without water. Yes, 3 weeks without water. Let's see people. The shortage of water in this region results in the shortage of the food. As such, not many people live in these areas. Here the population is very small. Most of the people in the desert reside in the rural area. What reside mean? Have one's permanent home in a particular place. Have one's permanent home in a particular place. The languages spoken are Rajasthani and Hindi. People keep moving from one place to another in search of food and water. These people are called nomads. So nomads means people keep moving from one place to another in search of food and water. They belong to Banjara community. The nomads are traveling traders and artisans. The nomads are traveling traders and artisans. They are engaged in animal rearing. They are engaged in animal rearing. One of the important place of Thar Desert is Rajasthan. The Great Indian Desert falls in the state of Rajasthan. The capital of Rajasthan is Jaipur. So what is the capital of Rajasthan? Jaipur. Jaipur is the capital of Rajasthan. Rajasthan means the abode of the Rajas. Rajasthan means the abode of Rajas. Why Rajasthan is called the abode of Rajas? Because of a royal history. Because of a royal history, Rajasthan is called the abode of the Rajas. Rajasthan is located in the northwestern part of India. It is surrounded in the north and northeast by the states of Punjab and Haryana. North and northeast by the states of Punjab and Haryana. To the east and southeast by the states of Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. East and southeast by the states of Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. And to the southwest by the state of Gujarat. Southwest by the states of Gujarat. And the Aravalli Range lies to the southeast. Aravalli Range, southeast. Some of the rivers which flow in Rajasthan are Chambal, Banas, Bangara and Luni. What kind of occupations are works done here? In the areas where water is available, agriculture is an important occupation of the people.
So, where water is available. Agriculture is an important occupation of the people. Farmers grow Java, Bajra, wheat and millet.
Grasses form the main natural resource of the desert. They provide nutrition to the animals and are also used for making medicines, oils and soaps. So, grasses form the main natural resource of the desert, which is the main natural resource of the desert. Which is the main natural resource of the desert? Grasses. How it is helpful? They provide nutrition to the animals and are also used for making medicines, oils and soaps. Next, cattle are reared for milk and sheep are reared for their wool. Cattle are reared for milk and sheep are reared for their wool.
Which is the main occupation in this state? Agriculture. Agriculture is the main occupation in this state. And tourism also helps to earn good revenue. Tourism also helps to earn good revenue. Revenue means income. And Rajasthan is a major wool producing state of India. Rajasthan is a major wool producing state of India.
Which are the famous places in the Thar Desert? Some of the important places of tourist interest in the state of Rajasthan. Which is the capital of Rajasthan? Jaipur. Jaipur is also known as the Pink City. It is the capital of Rajasthan. So, which is the capital of Rajasthan? Jaipur. Jaipur attracts tourists from all over the world. Other tourist destination includes Iska National Park in Alwar, Desert National Park in Jaisalmer, Sam and Guri Sand Dunes, Lake Palace in Udaipur, Amar Palace in Jaipur, Bharatpur National Park, Jodhpur. And Jodhpur is also known as Blue City and Sun City.
Why is Jodhpur called the Blue City?
Jodhpur is also known as Blue City as the houses are blue painted in the old area of the city. And it is also called as the Sun City because the weather remains bright and sunny all around the year. And to keep the houses cool, blue color is used on the houses. Jodhpur is also known as Blue City and Sun City.
Which are the important festivals? Some of the festivals celebrated in Rajasthan are Gango, Diwali, Holi, Diwali and Eid. And Baska festival near Ema is a form of mixed religious festival. It is a form of a mixed religious festival and livestock fair. Here farmers come to sell their cattle and camels. Let's see dresses. The traditional dress of Rajasthan is Ghagra Choli and Otni for women. The traditional dress of Rajasthan is Ghagra Choli and Otni. They also wear Ghagra with the long blouse and Otni called Posak. The Ghagra with the long blouse and Otni called Posak. Men wear dhotis, colorful turbans and kurtas. Let's see some minerals in Rajasthan. Rajasthan is an important producer of gemstones such as emerald and garnet.
Some of the minerals found here are lead, zinc, gypsum, and silver ore. What are the minerals are here? There are lead, zinc, gypsum, and silver ore. And marble, granite, and Tholpur stone are found in abundance. Marble, granite, and Tholpur stone are found in abundance. So children, what does the word abundance mean? It means a very large quantity of something. Let's talk about industries. Textile, minerals, wool, vegetable oil, and chemical are manufactured in Rajasthan. And handicrafts like marble inlay work, jewelry, pottery, and brass work are very famous all over the world. Let's recall about the Thar Desert. The western desert of India is rocky and sandy and lies towards west of the Aravalli Hills in Rajasthan and parts of Gujarat. This is the Great Indian Desert. It is also known as the Thar Desert. The Great Indian Desert, also known as the Thar Desert. It covers a large part of West Rajasthan. A desert is a flat area covered with a thick sheet of loose sand. Plants cannot grow in this region due to dry land and lack of water. Hot and dry winds are very cold. This region receives very hot and dry air during summer in daytime. The nights are very cold. Sand heats up quickly and cools faster than water. There is a very scanty rainfall. The government of Rajasthan is trying to provide water not only for household use but also for irrigating the fields. Water from River Satluj has been brought to the desert through the Rajasthan Canal, which is also called the Indira Gandhi Canal. So, Indira Gandhi Canal is also known as the Rajasthan Canal. It is still being built. When completed, it will be the longest canal in the world and make Rajasthan fertile. People from the cities and villages search for the spring water. Date palm, ginger, and bulb trees and grasses grow in these areas. A land with water and greenery in the desert is called oasis. Due to the lack of fertile soil and water, it is very difficult to grow crops. Wheat and millets are grown in some places where water is available. Date palms are also grown in such areas. There are very few cities lying in this region. They are Jodhpur and Jaisalmer. Indira Gandhi Canal starts from River Satluj and provides water to some of the parts of the Thar Desert. Villages are situated around in the oasis region. Women have to walk long distances to get water for domestic use.
Life in the desert is very hot due to the dry sand and lack of water. Only few crops are grown in the desert area. Some people travel from one place to another in search of food for themselves and their animals. Such people are called Banjaras or nomads. Camel is a very useful animal in the desert. It is called the sheep of the desert. Camel is also known as the sheep of the desert. It can walk easily on the sand and stay for days together without drinking water. It also provides milk and meat. Camel hair is used to make clothes and its skin is useful to make tent and some of the leather products. Most houses in the desert region have flat and small windows. The walls are thick to keep the heat away and let the house remain cool. Some houses have underground tanks to store water. Jaipur is the capital city of Rajasthan. It is called the Pink City. Rajasthan is the only state with desert which makes the tourist attracted. Hawa Mahal of Jaipur, the Jaisalmer Fort are the important places in the Rajasthan. People go in jeeps and enjoy camel safari to all these places throughout the year. Let's summarize. Sand dune, a small hills of sand formed due to the deposit of large amount of sand carried by wind. Sand dune, a small hills of sand formed due to the deposit of large amount of sand carried by wind. Nomads, a person who does not stay long in the same place. A person who does not stay long in the same place is called nomads. Scarcity, the state of being scarce or in short supply. The state of being scarce or in short supply is called scarcity. Scanty, a small or insufficient inequality or amount. Small or insufficient inequality or amount is called scanty. Oasis, a fertile spot in a desert where water is found. A fertile spot in a desert where water is found is called oasis. Hydroelectric, electricity that is produced by harnessing flowing water. Electricity that is produced by harnessing flowing water is called hydroelectric. Erosion, the process by which the surface of anything is gradually destroyed by the movement of wind, water, etc. The process by which the surface of anything is gradually destroyed by the movement of wind, water, etc. Sandstorms, a strong wind carrying clouds of sand with it, especially in a desert. A strong wind carrying clouds of sand with it is called sandstorms. Okay children, let us discuss about book exercise. Children, take your book and Write the answer without mistake. Page number 36. A. State whether the following statements are true or false. Question number 1. The Great Indian Desert lies towards the east of the Northern Plains. I will repeat you again. The Great Indian Desert lies towards the east of the Northern Plains. The answer is false. The Great Indian Desert lies towards the east of the Northern Plains. The answer is false. Because the Great Indian Desert is also known as the Thar Desert. It located in the northwestern part of India. That means the Thar Desert lies towards the northwest of the Northern Plains. So, the Great Indian Desert lies towards the east of the Northern Plains. False. Second, in the desert, only the plants of the cactus family grow. In the desert, only the plants of the cactus family grow. The answer is false. Date palm, giger, and babul trees and grasses grow in these areas. So, in the desert, only the plants of the cactus family grow. False. Third one. A place in the desert which has water and hence vegetation is called an oasis. A place in the desert which has water and hence vegetation is called an oasis. The answer is true. At some places in the desert, the underground water comes to the surface. Such a place in the desert which has water and thus vegetation is referred to as an oasis. So, a place in the desert which has water and hence vegetation is called an oasis. True. Fourth one. Desert can be hot as well as cold. Deserts can be hot as well as cold. The answer is true. The desert region receives very hot and the temperature in the desert can change drastically from day to night because the air is so dry that heat escapes rapidly at night. The daytime temperature averages 38 degrees Celsius, while some deserts it can get down to minus 4 degrees Celsius at night. So, deserts can be hot as well as cold. True. Fifth one. The Luni is the only river that drains into the Thar Desert. The Luni is the only river that drains into the Thar Desert. The answer is true. The only river that crosses these sands is the Luni. Luni is the largest river in the Thar Desert in northwest in India. So, the Luni is the only river that drains into the Thar Desert. I repeat you again. Question number 1. The Great Indian Desert lies towards the east of the Northern Plains. The answer is false. Second one. In the desert, only the plants of the cactus family grow. In the desert, only the plants of the cactus family grow. The answer is false. Third one. A place in the desert which has water, and hence vegetation is called an oasis. A place in the desert which has water and hence vegetation is called an oasis. The answer is true. Fourth one. Deserts can be hot as well as cold. Deserts can be hot as well as cold. The answer is true. Fifth one. The Luni is the only river that drains into the Thar Desert. The Luni is the only river that drains into the Thar Desert. The answer is true. Page number 37. B. Name the following. Question number 1. The capital of Rajasthan. The capital of Rajasthan. The answer is Jaipur. Jaipur is the capital of Rajasthan and it is also known as the Pink City. So, the capital of Rajasthan? Jaipur. Second one. Hot and dry winds blowing at very high speed, carrying clouds of sand. Hot and dry winds blowing at very high speed, carrying clouds of sand. The answer is sandstorms. A strong wind carrying clouds of sand with it, especially in a desert. Hot and dry winds blowing at very high speed, carrying clouds of sand. Sandstorms. Third one. People of the Thar Desert who keep moving from one place to another in search of food and water. People of the Thar Desert who keep moving from one place to another in search of food and water. Some people travel from one place to another in search of food for themselves and their animals. Such people are called Banjaras or nomads. So, people of the Thar Desert who keep moving from one place to another in search of food and water. Nomads. Fourth one. The Buskar Fair is held in this state. The Buskar Fair is held in this state. The answer is Rajasthan. The annual Buskar Fair is held in the Ajmer district of Rajasthan. So, the Buskar Fair is held in this state, Rajasthan. Fifth one. It is a rain-fed river in the Thar Desert. It is a rain-fed river in the Thar Desert. The answer is Luni River. The only river that crosses these sands is the Luni. It is rain-fed river in the Thar Desert. The rain-fed rivers are rivers that dry up in the summer, but it flows through the rainy season. It is a rain-fed river in the Thar Desert. Luni River. Children, I will repeat you again. The capital of Rajasthan, Jaipur. Second one. Hot and dry winds blowing at very high speed, carrying clouds of sand. Sandstorms. Third one. People of the Thar Desert who keep moving from one place to another in search of food and water. Nomads. Fourth one. The Buskar Fair is held in this state.
Rajasthan. Fifth one. It is a rain-fed river in the Thar Desert. Luni River. Thank you.